After that game Saturday, convincing win, you believe more Kentucky than Tennessee. Right now, the AP top 25, it came out today. Kentucky sitting at the fourth spot. Do you believe this is a number one seed?
I think they have the potential of being a number one seed. I'm not sure I'm willing to give them that just yet because I don't think that we're that far away. And as many people might say, well, man, Kentucky's just been kind of dominating a lot of games outside of that LSU game. And where you say that, I might tend to agree with you. I don't think that their schedule has been nearly as beefed up, if you will, within the SEC conference where you really only have those three teams, in my personal opinion, that I think are contenders to make any kind of guaranteed, you know, second round or third round Sweet 16 advancement between Tennessee, Kentucky, and LSU. But just looking at it, you know, I don't think that we're really that far away from seeing them when we saw the way that they played at Alabama and against Seton Hall on a neutral site at Madison Square Garden. I don't think we're that far away from that. It wouldn't surprise me if they turned around and I can't remember right off the back if they have to go to Tennessee this year before the conference tournament, but it wouldn't surprise me if they went to Tennessee and they got blown out. That wouldn't surprise me. It wouldn't surprise me if that team didn't even have to beat Tennessee. You know, so from that standpoint, I think right now I think they're really, really probably the best two seed in my opinion, or the second best two seed in my opinion. But I think hands down right now, just to be fair about everything, I think Tennessee is still a one seed. I think Gonzaga is probably going to be the one seed at this point. And also Virginia and Duke. And if one of those four teams is not a one seed, I don't think Kentucky is next in line. I think that Michigan is probably next in line, but Kentucky is certainly on the heels of not only Michigan, but every number one seed out there that's not named Duke.
Okay, so I'm assuming you think that in that second matchup with Tennessee and Kentucky, Tennessee is going to win that second game.
I don't know. I think it's going to be a much closer game than the game was just played the other day at Tennessee. I mean, against Tennessee at Rupp Arena against Kentucky. That's tough. You put me on the spot.
I know I did. I was just like, because you're saying Tennessee a number one seed. I'm thinking, okay.
No, that's okay. That's your job. You have to take your good tricks, take. I think in that case, I'm going to go with Tennessee in that game. I don't really want to, but I think I'd have to go with Tennessee at home in that game in the event that they play a second game. I need to check out the calendar, see if they're going to play another game at Tennessee before conference tournament. But if not, or if they don't play, or in the event that Kentucky has to go to Tennessee and gets a win against Tennessee and sweeps the series in the regular season, I think if they meet up in the conference tournament, in that case, I don't see Kentucky beating Tennessee in the event that they meet up in the conference tournament somewhere and beating Tennessee three times in a row. I don't see that happening. So I know that's probably not a very direct way of answering your question, but believe that I'd certainly be pulling for Kentucky in that game versus Tennessee. I'm just not a believer just yet. Tennessee got to show.